Hello everybody, welcome to Indian Judicial Service. Today we are taking a very important topic, Code of Criminal Procedure, Act 1973. This is the procedure code and which provide the procedure, how the police work, how the court work, and what is the measures taken by police or court to maintain peace and law and order. So today in this part we cover question 1 to 15 question. In this video series we cover 400 most important question of CRPC. Before starting this part and from question 1, I will provide here some important points belong to CRPC. So Code of Criminal Procedure come into the force 1st April. So CRPC is come into 1st April 1974. It contains 37 chapters. So CRPC contains 37 chapters and total sections here 484 sections. And there are two schedules. These schedules are very important, especially first one. First one schedule provided that sections of offenses which are provided in IPC Indian Penal Code 1860. And second point here, offense. First schedule also provide the offense, definition of offense in short way. And third point here, punishment. The first schedule also provide the punishment of given section. And it also classifies the offense is cognizable and non-cognizable, and bailable and non-bailable, and what court trial above a punishment or sections. Now start here. Question number 1. As per a Code of Criminal Procedure Act 2008 with effect from 31st December 2009, which inserted the clause WA. WA provided the victim, definition of victim. So victim in section 2 in CRPC defining the victim as a person who has suffered by any loss or injury caused by reason of the act or omission for which the accused has been charged, including victim's guardian and legal here, victim neighbor and victim close friend. So in this question answer is here victim guardian and legal here. Question number 2. According to section 41A subsection 1 of CRPC as inserted by the Code of Criminal Procedure Act 2008, it is amended act and amended in August 2010, the police officer shall issue a notice directing the alleged cause through he has committed a cognizable offense to appear before him or at such other as specify in notice in all the cases where the arrest of person is not required under provision of subsection 1A of section 41, provision of subsection 1B of section 41, provision of subsection 1C of section 41, provision of subsection 1 of section 41. Yes, it is answered here. Provision of subsection 1 of section 41. Question number 3. Within the meaning of provision under section 41, C1 of a criminal procedure code which was inserted by the Code of Criminal Procedure Amendment Act 2008. Every state shall establish the police control, this is very important, police control PCR in every district, yes it is every district, and every state in every state level only. So here answer is option C, both district and state level. So section 41C subsection 1 provided that the police control, which is established by the state government at every state level or at every district level. Question number 4. The criminal procedure code, which come under the concurrent list of a constitution of India, is unduly rigid and does not make room for any special law and procedure. Not duly rigid and make a room for any special law and procedure, and generally gives the procedure to a such special law and procedure. And not duly rigid and make a room for any special procedure, but generally gives the procedure and to the law and procedure given under the code. So here answer is option B, because in this option C there is a but here answer here and. So the criminal procedure code is not duly rigid, and it also provides a room for any other procedure, special procedure provided by the act and many other acts, and which having the procedural as well as substantive features. So their special procedure prevail over the CRPC. Question number 6. What is a true to code of criminal procedure? It is mainly thou, not purely, and adjective or procedural law. There are also certain provisions which are partly in nature of substantive law. So code of criminal procedure, it is mainly a procedural law, but it has some part which provide the nature of substantive law, like section 125. So answer is here option C, both A and B. Question number 6. Which classification of offense come under a criminal procedure code? Cognizable, non-cognizable, bailable, non-bailable, summon case, warrant case. So option D is correct here, all of the above. Classification of offense given in the code of criminal procedure. Section 320, Schedule 1st, Schedule 2nd, and Section 482. I already expressed there. So section Schedule 1st is provided that the classification of offense. The offense is cognizable, non-cognizable, bailable, non-bailable, such type of classification. Question number 8. The cognizable offense under CRIPC has been defined. Cognizable offense under Section 2A CRPC, under Section 2C CRPC, under Section 2I CRPC, under Section 2L CRPC. So here answer is C, under Section answer is B, under Section 2C of CRPC. Question number 9. In cognizable case under IPC, the police has the authority to arrest. So I think it is CRPC. In cognizable case under CRPC, the police has authority to arrest the person without warrant. This is very important point here. This thing is provided in 2C, means definition of cognizable offense. The cognizable offense are those offense where the police officer arrest any person without warrant, if it is specially mentioned in Schedule 1st. Option B, authority to investigate. First here, without arrest, without warrant, and second one, authority to investigate the offense without permission of magistrate, without permission. So both options are here correct. So here answer is C, A and B. Question number 10. In cognizable case under IPC, again right here IPC, CRPC. The police will have all the power. Investigate in cognizable case. First here we centralize in mind word cognizable. The investigate accept the power to arrest without warrant. Accept. The investigate include the power to arrest without warrant. Investigate and arrest without warrant after seeking the permission of magistrate, and the investigate and arrest without warrant only after informing the magistrate. So option B is correct here, because I previously expressed that the cognizable offense where the police officer arrest without warrant and without permission of magistrate, and cognizable offense are defined other classified in schedule first. So option B is correct here. Question number 11. A magistrate has a power to direct a police to investigate into an offense in IPC under. Again, it write here IPC. This is wrong. Here, write is CRPC. Section 156(1) of CRPC, 156(2) of CRPC, 156(3) of CRPC, all of the above. So here answer is 156(3) of CRPC. 6C, provided that any magistrate in power under section 90, the 90 section provided that the power of magistrate to take cognizance, and it has a power to take cognizance on police report on complaint and suo motu. Three procedure and to take a cognizance. So in this section, subsection 3 of section 56, provided that the any magistrate in power to take cognizance under section 90 order a such investigation which are provided that section 56 subsection 1 of section 56. Question number 12. A magistrate has power under sections under CRPC to direct the police officer to investigate into non-cognizable offense, cognizable offense, only non-cognizable offense as in a cognizable offense, and police is under a duty to investigate. Option D, both A and B. So here answer is option D, both A and B. The magistrate have power to instruct the police to take investigation, to start investigation. In cognizable case, under section 56 subsection 3, and in non-cognizable case under section 155 subsection 2. The police magistrate having a power to instruct the police to start investigation under these two sections. Question number 13. In a non-cognizable case, under again here IPC, CRPC, the police officer has the authority to investigate into offense without order and giving by magistrate, but cannot arrest the accused without warrant. To investigate and even arrest the accused without warrant. Neither, here important word is non-cognizable case, neither to investigate order of magistrate nor can be arrest the accused without warrant. So option C is correct here, and option D is here, cannot investigate without order of magistrate and but can arrest. So it is wrong here. So option C is correct. Question number 13. Now question number 14. Non-cognizable offense has been defined. Non-cognizable under section 2A, no, under section 2C, it is also not wrong here, under section 2I, no, not. And option D is correct here, under section 2L, it is not 1, it is L, under section 2L. Last question here in this video. A case which include cognizable offence and non-cognizable offence is the cognizable case but require a sanction of magistrate, for investigation into the non-cognizable part under section 55(2) of CRPC. A cognizable case, and as such the investigation of a case does not require any sanction of magistrate under section 55(2) of CRPC. Non-cognizable case, and such as such the investigation of case require a sanction of magistrate under section 55(2) of CRPC. Option D, non-cognizable case but does not require a sanction of magistrate under section 55(2) of CRPC. So here answer is option B. If there are combination of cognizable and non-cognizable, so in such situation, according to section 155 subsection 4, here 5, it is 5, 155 subsection 4, provided that if the combination of two or more offense and their one offense is cognizable and remaining is non-cognizable, the whole case is treated as cognizable offense and the police officer having a same power as cognizable offense. So the case is treated as cognizable case, and as such the investigation of case does not require any sanction of magistrate. There is no need to permission of magistrate under section 55(2) of CRPC. So thank you for watching this video. Please like and share this video to your friend and relatives, and don't forget to subscribe our channel. Thank you.